Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Today we are going to understand programmable logic controller. This is the trainer kit. The order code for this trainer kit is 52015. In this trainer kit, we are providing Siemens Max Simatic S7200 series smart PLC. The CPU code is CPU-SR30, and these are the toggle switches which are internally connected to the input terminals, and these are the output, and there are the LED also for indications. When the output on, the LED will operate as the output on, and these are the relay of 5 volt and relay terminals, NO terminals with relay control supply will be provided at this socket. And these are the 24 volt ground positive 5 volt terminal, and these are the M and L terminal which are connected internally to the input and output terminals as well. Now, for communication of this PLC, we will use a LAN cable, and there is a port for connecting the LAN cable to the PLC. The other end of the LAN cable is connected to PC. Now, for programming of this PLC, we are using Siemens Step 7 Microwin Smart Software. So, we start the software. Now, we go to PLC mode. And first we select the model. The model of PLC is SR30, we have selected here, and press OK. Now, for programming of this PLC, we first select NC bit and give this NC bit an address which is the input 0, and now here we select the output and give this output address which is output 0. Now this is the first NC block program, which is our first experiment also. In the NC condition, when the supply is not present, the output will not be operated or not be on. When the supply is present at this terminal in NC, the output when the supply is present, the output will automatic output will on. Now we download this program to PLC by this download button. Here the communication, this is our PLC's IP which is automatically detected by the software. Now we press OK, and the message shows download blocks by the CPU. So we download these blocks to CPU by pressing this download button. The program prompted that the CPU is in stop, CPU is in run mode, so we have to place the CPU to stop mode first. So we have to place yes. And now program is downloaded and we turn back to the PLC to run mode. So we have to again press yes. Now download completed. Now, as our PLC has been programmed, the NC logic is programmed to the PLC. Now, we connect there the terminal for LED indications. We first connect M to ground with these page codes, and we connect plus 5 volt to L. This will give the supply to LED. Now, to understand the program, we have started simulation. We compare this, the simulation passed, and press continue. Now, as we operate the toggle switch of input number 0, the output of 0 number will be on. So, here we perform the this operation by pressing this toggle switch on. Here we can see in simulation also, the input is on and the output is on as well. Same here at the kit. The input is on, the output is on. this is the NC logic we are performing here. Now at experiment number 2, we are going to understand the NC logic. In NC condition, we first select the NC bit from here and give it the input 0 address. Now we select an output coil and give it the output 0 address. Now again we download this program to PLC by pressing download, place the CPU in stop mode and then place it to run mode again and close this download. Now we start the simulation from here. In NC condition, when the power supply is not given to the input, the output will be operated, and when the power supply is given to the input, the output will not operate it. So this is the NC condition. In this time we are giving the output to the the input to the PLC, which is showing the input is coming to the PLC but output is not on. And as we off the output, as we off the input, the output will automatically on. So this is the NC logic. When the when the input is off, the output is will remain on, and when the input is on, the output will goes to off. Now in experiment number 3, we are going to use counter up. For this, first we have to use an NO logic and give it to input 0. And now from these bits here we can see there are counters. Open this and select CTU, which is counter up. So first we have to give the counter address, which is C0, and here we select the process value. So we will select a preset value as 5. Now for resetting the counter, we again select an NO input, and now we select input 1 for resetting this counter. And now here we can select an NO logic and give this the counter 0 address. So it will act as the when the count process preset value has reached to the 5 counts, the output will on. So now here we select the output by operating this counter. The programming has been done. Now we have to download this program. And start the simulation. So at the kit, as the input 0 again and again reaches 5 count, after 5 count the output will come. This is the count up section. Now for the as the preset value reaches the 5 counts, the output goes on. For resetting these counts, we have given the input 1 at the program. So as we press the input 1 on, the counter resets. And now again when we give the input 5 times to the PLC, the counter's process value will be processed and the output will occur after the 5 times. This is the condition in which many industrial scenario counting is required for many inputs. So this is the counting up and down program. In simulation we can also see the process value is set as the set at the 5. Now at the present time, as we off the input, the counted value actual time is 0. As we press the input on, the process value goes to 1. Then again we press, the process value goes to 2, and again as 3, 4, and now 5. So after 5 counts, the output prompted here from the counter has done counting to the 5 times and the output given. Here is the process going. Now for resetting the counter, we have to press the input 1. So as we press the input 1, the counter again goes to the 0 counts. This is the counter up process in this PLC trainer. So there are many processes we can do at this experiment. For further this, we can consider, you can consider the manual and Texca Technologies Private Limited.